After more than a week of speculation, the federal government is finally releasing its COVID-19 stimulus package later this morning. The grand plan it hopes will save us from recession.
The focus will be on keeping business humming and people in jobs. Here to talk us through the plan is Prime Minister Scott Morrison. PM, good morning to you.
Good morning, Carl. Good day, Alec.
We saw that announcement from the World Health Organization a little earlier, declaring a pandemic. They accused us not so long ago of overreacting. They have a lot to answer for, don't they?
Well, we made this call 2 weeks ago, as you know, and initially back in January, we also made the call to take this very seriously. And that has enabled Australia to prepare and get ahead, not just on the economic measures that we're announcing today, which we've been working steadily on, but also the health response to this as well. Yesterday, we announced $2.4 billion. That's putting money into hospitals, into pop-up clinics, into testing, into making sure people can get their medicines, telehealth, support for remote communities, face masks. So dealing with the health issues, dealing with the economic issues to keep Australians in jobs, to keep business in business, and to ensure we bounce back strongly on the other side of this.
Okay, well, there are strong suggestions this morning that the package could be up to $20 billion. Can we afford it, firstly, and when will it roll out?
Well, we've worked hard to get the budget back in balance, and that was acknowledged by an S&P, one of the big ratings agencies, overnight, which puts us in a position to make this sort of response. And that's why you actually do that and get your budget under repair. And this will be rolling out over the course of this next quarter. It'll start in April. We'll get the legislation sorted out when we come back to Parliament in a week, and that legislation will now be drafted, having settled these measures. But an important one today, I mean, there's around 120,000 apprentices who would be at risk. And we're going to pay half their wage with their employers for those small business employers who are putting on apprentices. I think it's fantastic that small business puts on apprentices, and this is going to ensure that we help them carry that load through this virus. We're giving support to businesses of up to $50 million in turnover with grants of up to $25,000, and that will just come automatically through their what's called the business activity statement, the BAS process. So they don't have to fill out any forms, and they don't have to make any applications, and no one has to come and go through their books. This is just an automatic payment that they'll receive, and it's based on businesses that employ people. This is all about keeping people in jobs.
PM, pensioners, as you would know, are really scared right now. They've got little money anyway. There is a concern that they won't spend this injection.
Well, that certainly hasn't been the history every time these sorts of things have been done. Those who will target and will announce those payments a little later today, those groups that we'll be working with to provide that stimulus to the economy, the experience has always been that that has flowed through very quickly to the economy. And that's why I think it's important to have the health measures in place as well, Carl. That's the difference, I suppose, with this event, is this is about a health crisis. This is not a financial crisis. It is a global health crisis. Australia's not immune from that, but what we can do is take the action. I mean, another important measure today is the instant asset write-off. Now, this allows businesses to write off purchases of equipment that they're putting into their business, which they may have planned to do, particularly over the next 3 months. Well, this will give them the confidence to go ahead, because they'll be able to write off completely, 100%, $150,000 worth of investment in each and every item. That's for businesses up to $500 million a year in turnover. So that's about putting the investment into the economy. So on the other side, the economy bounces back and the jobs are strengthened even further and the budget bounces back, because this package does not have expenditure into the never-never. It's targeted, it's now, it's to support us here and now.
When is the other side? When do you expect us to get through this?
Well, we don't have a finite view on that at the moment, and we're having another meeting of the National Security Committee today where we're getting further advice from our medical experts. They've been doing a lot of work on this, working with people overseas. But what we do know about viruses is that they do have a fixed life, whether it's 6 months, whether it's 9 months. I mean, these sorts of things are not yet determined. But we do know they do have a finite life, and there is another side to this. And what I'm really pleased about, Carl, and Ali, is that I called on big business earlier this week to do their bit. And we've already seen Qantas step up, and we've seen the big banks pass through that rate cut. First time that's happened by all of them in 5 years. And last night, Telstra told me, Andy Penn told me, that for casual employees, they're going to be ensuring that they get looked after if they have to go into self-isolation. That's the sort of thing I was asking big businesses to do.
Okay,
they've got the balance sheets, and so does the federal government, and we're going to be supporting, and I'm pleased to see that they're following that lead.
Okay, so you're relying on business to do that. You won't be supporting the 3.3 million... casual workers if they're in a situation where they're isolated?
Oh no, there are payments in the welfare system that can be targeted to those sorts of things. I'll have a bit more about to say about that today.
Like
my simple point is well, I'll talk about that later today, Carl. Okay. What I am saying is big business has a role to play in this as well, and I'm pleased at the early signs of them doing that. Our state governments have a role to play, and we all do actually at the end of the day, Carl, whether it's making sure that the reporting of the information is clear and based on the facts from the medical experts, or whether it's, you know, people helping out their neighbours if they've got on self-isolation. We've all got a role to play. We've got ahead early, but we've got to stay ahead. That's not something the government takes for granted. But all Australians will keep our heads and we'll get through this.
Is it your belief that this package is enough to keep us out of a recession?
It's well targeted, but it's just under about 1% of the size of our economy. So that's a very significant injection, and it happens very quickly over the next quarter. So that's very important, but it's scalable. We're in a position to ramp this up should that be required further. And as you've probably seen from this, we've learnt more and more about this virus almost every day, and we've responded to that information. We've not been reckless about this. We've been very careful about it because we know on the other side we're going to bounce back. We're going to bounce back strongly.
Okay, so it's $20 billion at this stage, give or take.
Well, as I said, it's scalable, Carl. I mean, we've got a budget coming up in a few months, just over a month's time, and the government is always in a position to do what we need to do. Because we worked so hard to get the budget back into balance, that gives us the platform. I mean, overnight, Standard & Poor's confirmed our AAA credit rating. They said that what we've been able to do puts Australia in a position to deal with the temporary shock of this virus. And that how long that goes for, whether it's 6 months or a bit less than that or a bit more than that, we're well positioned to deal with it.
Prime Minister, we know that this will get worse before it gets better. Can we expect our borders to be closed at some point? Is that on the table?
Well, once a virus moves into a real sort of global pandemic phase, and we've got more than 100 countries that are now affected by this, the medical advice to us is that those measures become less and less effective because Australians are still returning from wherever they've been, whether it's the United States or the United Kingdom or many countries that to this point in time have been less affected by the virus. What matters is then how you manage it within the community, and that's why we scaled up the investment in our health system with over 100 pop-up clinics and money for additional testing. And on the testing, just a point the medical officer made yesterday. You've got to be presenting symptoms. You would have had to have had contact with someone directly that would have been either had the virus or been in a country where it had been quite exposed to it. Just rushing off and having a test when you're not presenting any symptoms on the maybe, that test is not going to do you any good. It's not going to tell you anything. So listen to the medical advice, not to Twitter.
Do you do you worry about your wife and kids getting it?
Well, one of the things that the medical officer said, Carl, is that for the vast majority of Australians who would contract this virus, it'll be a mild illness, as Dr. Murphy has said. And so whether I would have contracted or you were attracted, the other thing is it's shown no severity, particularly towards younger people and especially children. The more risk at-risk populations are the older population. That's what we've seen. That's why we put an additional $100 million into support for aged care facilities yesterday. The $500 million that we're putting into the state hospital system also helps them support the aged care system. We put money into support remote Indigenous communities yesterday. If there were to be an outbreak in those communities, we can react. So there's been a lot of thought go through into the planning of how we'll respond on the health side and on the economic side, because together we will get through this and we'll get through it strongly.
PM, thanks for your time.